afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni and
Anne-Marie Gianni.
And today is Tuesday, and we're here on beautiful, the beautiful Marina Del Rey Beach. That's what we wanted to say.
Mm-hmm.
And we're here, we're just hanging out, and this is why the video is a little late. The sun is setting, we're chilling out, and we're going to answer some of your questions. All right, so here we go. We got some questions here, just chilling out. You know, I have to say we really do live a blessed life to be able to be here on the beach and be able to answer your questions. We really appreciate that. And thanks for watching, guys. We really seriously appreciate that. We want you to be here with us. So that's the question. The question of the day is going to be, what is it going to take for you guys to be here with us? But first off, let's get into the questions here. Question is, I was talking about chocolate, and someone asked, are you aware of any other food supplements or spices that might have a similar mineral depletion effect on the body if eaten in large amounts too regularly? My energy levels aren't typically low, but I have some sort of itchy skin rash that comes and goes, and it gets worse with heat and sweat. I eat turmeric, cumin, cayenne regularly, nearly daily. I'm wondering if this might be the cause, if you've ever read anything about it. So when it comes to things that may cause, you know, mineral depletion, it's not necessarily the food. I mean, there are some foods that are, you know, they're very strong diuretics that may actually cause you to lose some minerals. But really, you want to look at stimulants. So if you're eating any sort of stimulants, you want to look very closely at your mineral levels and see how they're working. So for instance, chocolate's a stimulant, coffee's a stimulant, some herbal teas can be a stimulant, and they can actually deplete your minerals. So that's something to look at. And it wouldn't necessarily be, you know, what you're particularly doing or you know, plus or minus. It really is more an issue of, again, you know, how are you overstimulating the body? And let's put it this way, not just with foods or herbs, you can also look at things like your stress levels too. Excessive exercise can also deplete your minerals. So anything that's going to really spin the body too fast, create too much warmth, may actually cause a depletion of minerals. But again, you know, use the whole picture here. You know, get tested and see how your mineral levels are. Don't just, you know, assume that, you know, what you're doing is or isn't working. Let's get tested and see. Use a hair test for your minerals and see if you're actually depleting your minerals, or see if you're fine. Then you won't have to worry about it. Good.
Mm-hmm.
Question number two is, I have a problem with my scalp. It's dry and flaky. I have dreadlocks, and I've had them for 8 years. I use cold-pressed virgin olive oil on my food, and I eat avocados, but I need help with my dry scalp. Any information would be greatly appreciated. Okay, so this is a great question. What it seems like to me, and I can't, you know, assess or address any sort of specific issue you may be having, but what I would do first is I would look at increasing the amount of omega-3 oils in your diet. So the avocado and the olive oil, while they are good oils, they are high in omega-6 oil, so they're not really high in omega-3 oil. So maybe, I don't know this for sure, but putting some omega-3 oils into your diet might actually fully kind of round out the essential fatty acid profile that you have and cause some of that dry, flaking skin to go away. I know for me, you know, omega-3 oils were particularly important in kind of bringing, you know, some moisture back to my skin, being in dry climates. So being in areas like the desert, being in Arizona and things like that, the omega-3 oils really helped. Adding those into my diet really helped to bring back the, you know, the bounciness, the vibrancy of my skin. Question number three, Shoshana says, I like that name. I just read your vitamin C GMO warning. Here's a question I have about liposomal vitamin C. Is this corn GMO too? I have a friend who's doing vitamin C drips. Is this the same problem? It's really important if you answer this. Okay, so what I would do is I don't know what particular product you're using. For those of you who want to know what liposomal vitamin C or liposomal anything is, it's a very small nanoparticle, and the absorption is actually better in your body. So when you use it, the absorption tends to be better. Is your vitamin C or liposomal vitamin C from corn? I don't know. It might be. And so what I would do is I would call your manufacturer and ask them. And if your manufacturer can't give you a straight answer, I would try another product. And that's the approach I would take. I think it's probably the best approach, because I don't want to just say, hey, you know, yes or no, it is or it isn't. But you do need to watch out for your vitamin C products, because most of them are from corn. And generally the corn that they're using is corn that has been genetically modified. So you just want to be careful, you know. And it's not necessarily that getting your vitamin C from genetically modified corn will give you health problems. That's not necessarily what I'm talking about. It's just when you buy your vitamin C from a GMO source, you're supporting GMO. So you're voting like, yes, GMO's okay. So we want to make sure that we don't do that. We don't support that practice in that way, even if it doesn't affect us in terms of our health significantly. We want to make sure we don't vote for it, because we're really messing with nature. And you know, just on that almost philosophical level, that's where it starts to go wrong. You know, there's other arguments and things like that, but that's where it starts to go wrong, and then it builds from there. Question number four is, do you have a whistle? Question number four is, do you have a face shaving cream that you can recommend? We're working on it. Right now I use Bronner's, but it seems to leave my skin a little bit dry after I'm done. We're working on a product through Anne-Marie's line that'll be a real effective lotion for shaving, as well as one that's pH balanced so it doesn't dry out your skin. So Nick, just stay tuned for that. We'll be coming out with it soon. Two more questions. What do you think I should buy first, a dehydrator or a high-speed blender? High-speed blender, hands down, you're going to get more use out of it. So final question here. Hi, Kevin. What are some of the symptoms of someone who's consumed GMO? It's in so many products already. Is it constant stomach pain, heavy feeling in the brain, legs that are jittery at night? Do you know if it's restless leg syndrome or something like that? Okay, so when we heard Jeffrey Smith talk, who's pretty much the leader in terms of GMO, compiling GMO research, he has a book called Genetic Roulette. And this book is literally, it's about this big, it's about like a textbook. And it's literally hundreds of pages of different studies that they've done with GMO foods. That's the best source to look at. Some of the ones that I know offhand, one specific study has shown gut imbalance. So some of the DNA from the genetically modified organisms that has actually started to grow and change, not necessarily grow, let me rephrase that, has actually started to combine with your gut DNA, creating different types of genetic material in your gut. So that's really scary in itself, because it's actually messing with your own gut flora. And then allergies. Allergies is another really big topic. You know, a lot of countries where they're growing GMO food and they're dealing with it, you know, hands-on, and even the animals are eating it, there actually has been cases, and you can see it in the book Genetic Roulette by Jeffrey Smith. You can see where cases of animals have died, skin rashes, things like that, people having ill health. So that's something really important to look at. So we don't necessarily know, you know, what's the one symptom or the two symptom or the three symptom. It's variable. And, you know, generally when you have foreign matter in your system, the allergy response is the first thing that comes about, and that's generally what happens. So your question of the day is this. I had mentioned it before, and I really want to know this. You know, what's it going to take for you to get to, you know, a freedom that you really want and deserve? I mean, I think freedom for me is the most important. Maybe that's not even something that you value, but, you know, what's it going to take to get you that freedom that you want and deserve? I'd like to know. Go ahead and post it down below. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.